Hello everyone. I hope that everyone is safe and healthy, and that you follow the instructions of how to keep safe and healthy. Today I'm gonna give a lesson regarding the step two for the Every Child a Musician exam. Some of you are very interested to do it, so I'm gonna help you to do it in the best way, and we're gonna follow step by step. I'm gonna try to give you a guidance how to make it easier for you to go through this book. All right, so well, let's start. All right, before, just to do a little recap. If you are looking forward to do the step two for Every Child a Musician, first you have to be sure that you were able to do that, you did the step one, all right? And for the step one, you should be able to play this Aonox dictionary from the yellow book. All right, so okay, so because this step two is much more difficult, remember that we're gonna be working using this book. Okay, you need to use the two books. All right, so remember, you have to have these two books, this one and this one, you have to use all the time. Okay, now last year and also last term, during the lessons, we were able to figure out how to locate these notes on the guitar. So if you've been practicing enough, you will be able to remember these songs, these notes by heart, all right? Very, very important. You need to know that notes by heart, okay? What can I tell you, all right? Very, very important is that if you want to, if you don't remember, okay? If you don't remember how to play these notes on the guitar, the Aonox dictionary that is on the page 11 of the yellow book, if you don't know how to play the guitar, just remember the basics, and the basics are, okay, the number inside the ring is gonna tell you the string. Remember, a string in a ring, so if it is written number 3, it means that if you want to play the notes G and A, you have to use a string 3, okay? If you want to play B, C and D, you have to use these three notes are on the string 2. And if you want to play E, F and G, you have to use the string 1, okay? So remember, a string in a ring. The other numbers that you see here is the numbers of the fret that you have to press, okay? So these are the numbers of the fret that you have to press, okay? So you need to be able to remember that, okay? Let's start to play, for example, the string G, okay? Let's start to play string by string, okay? String G, okay? To play a string G, you have to go to your string 3, okay? String 3, and you need to play the open string, because it's 0, it means that you don't press any fret. So string 3, fret 0. So it should sound like this, okay? If you want to play A, you have to press on the string free, because this line is mean that you keep going on the string free, and you need to press the fret 2. Okay, so it should sound like A. Okay, if you press B, okay, you want to play B, should be on the string, A 2, fret 0. Okay, you remember how it sound? If you go to C, you need to press the string 2, because it's still in the string 2, fret 1. If you want to play D, string 2, fret 3. And if you want to play E, string 1, fret 0. You see the 0 here? You want to press F, you want to play F, string 1, fret 1. And if you want to play G, string 1, fret 3. Okay? Very, very important. Okay? That's very important. Okay? To start to do this book, the step 2, the easy exercise to learn, to start, is with this one, alright? The exercise 4. Because all the notes that we have learned are inside of this exercise, okay? So that is what you need to remember, okay? So very, very important, alright? Alright, so I'm gonna help you to find the notes. I hope that you can see the notes here, alright? And the idea is to start to find the notes for the exercise 4, okay? So for example, what should be the name of the first note? What should be the name of this note, okay? Right? Not this one, the first one here, okay? So as you realize, this one is under the top line, okay? So when you check and to find the notes here, what is the note that is under the top line? So the only note that is under the top line is E, right? Okay, is that one. So what I do is I write on the top, I put like this, I wrote E, okay? That's gonna make you easier. You shouldn't do that, you shouldn't write, you should memorize the notes by heart, but anyways, can help you, all right? So what should be the name of the next note? What should be the name of the next note? If the next note is still under the top line, so it should be the same note, all right? So it should be E. And if you carry on, you realize that they are E, 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 E. So that's very easy. For that reason, we start with this exercise. Because on the first bar, all the notes are E. Do you want to try to put the notes for the second bar? Try it by yourself, okay? I'm gonna give you a little time. I'm gonna write the notes here, okay? And if you did it, okay, I don't want to show you now, okay, so let me put a pen here, okay, now if you check, for the second bar, you put closer, the notes are on the second line from the top to the bottom, all right? So if you check here, the only note, if you check on your page 11, where is the A note dictionary, okay? If you check the only note that is on the second line from the bottom to the top, from the top to the bottom, is D, all right? So I write D, okay? And that's it. It's a, it shouldn't be more difficult than that. So I want you to carry on and try to put the rest of the notes, to write the letters on the rest of the notes. So I'm gonna give you some time. You can put pause to this video, all right? And later, when you finish, put play again. And later we check if we have the same notes written. Okay. Right. So this is how how it will look if you write all the notes correctly. Okay. There is no more than that. Okay. Now what you have to do is to start to put these notes on the guitar, all right? That is the difficult thing, but if you've been practicing and if you remember the notes by heart, you will make that, you will be able to do that without any problem, all right? There is no more things to know. It's very, very easy. The only thing that now you need to remember is for how long you're gonna hold the notes. Remember that you have different symbols here, okay? You see, for example, you're gonna see this symbol, okay? If you remember very well, you know that this is a crochet that lasts for one beat, okay? And this is another crochet that lasts one beat, but this one is a quaver. And quaver, remember that they always are together most of the time because they last for half beat, so they are faster. This is another crochet, and they are four quavers, so that part is quite fast. And careful is this one, okay? Right? That note, we were learning this note on the lesson. And that note is different to the rest of the other ones. It's called the crochet dotted. And this one lasts for 1.5. And because it's 1.5, it's always coming with this quaver that lasts for half. Okay, so 1.5 plus 1.5 is 2. Remember. We were learning this one, these two notes, as the jumping note, because it's like a jumping. It's a little longer, and after you jump, you have the crochet, all right? It's quite confusing, but what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna sing for you the notes, okay? I'm gonna sing the rhythm, so later when you're gonna play in the guitar, it's gonna be easier. Now, for this exercise 4, this one is the most difficult part. So if you challenge yourself, try to do practice only this line. The other line is gonna be easier because you already know these tempos. You know how to play the correct notes here. And also you don't have this note here that lasts for 1.5. So this is the only part that is quite difficult. But the rest should be easier, okay? So if you do it right, it should sound like this, okay? So remember after 4, because we have this symbol here, it means common time, it means 4-4, okay, DC, right? And it should be, that should be, all right, should be like this. 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. E, 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 D, 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 C, B, B, A, G, A, B. Right? So this is the most difficult part. The rest part, I'm sure that you will manage to do it. So let's do it again. Try to sing with me, and after four. Remember, this is gonna last a little longer, and this one is short. We call it the jumping note. Tam, pam, pam. Remember? Let's do it again. 1, 2, 3, 4. E, 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 E. D, 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 D. C, B, B, A, G, A, B. And that's it. You are able to remember how to play the notes in the guitar. Now I'm gonna show you how to sound. Okay? I'm gonna put this here. You can see. Okay? So I take my guitar. Okay, I put the posture, the correct posture, okay, and remember that you're gonna be using the walking technique, okay, I don't gonna show you that already, you know how to use your right hand. Remember to keep the thumb on the top string to give you support, and it should sound like this. 1, 2, 3, 4. E, 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 D, 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 C, B, B, A, G, A, B. That's it. No more than that. It's very easy. I'm gonna do it again, but this time I don't gonna sing, so you can hear clearly how it sounds the guitar. 1, 2, 3, 4. That's it. The second line of the exercise is really, really easy. So now what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna play only the first line, okay? And later I'm gonna play the two lines, okay? I don't gonna sing, okay? But you can hear how it's gonna sound, the whole exercise. If you can play the first line, it means that you can play the second line very, very, very easy, all right? So let's do it together. 1, 2, 3, 4. Second line. To play this exercise, okay, it's called exercise 4, so you can start to prepare yourself for the exam by doing this exercise. Remember, the exercise 4 is very, very important, all right, later you can play exercise 4, you will be able to get ready for the exam, okay. I'm gonna make another video, help you with another exercise, but we leave it like that until this moment. Practice, remember to practice your 8-note dictionary from the yellow book. Remember this note by heart. write the notes on the exercise 4, okay? And practice on the guitar, okay? Bye-bye. Stay safe. Take care.